Hey guys, DannyVNCR here. Today, doing another Danny Plays with Friends. We're playing Rides with Strangers. I'm here with my good buddy, Brady. Is it Secules? Is that how you pronounce your last name?
Good buddy that you don't know how to say my last name.
Yeah, exactly.
Secules.
Your headphones are on backwards, by the way.
Oh, shit. Thanks.
It could matter. It might not. Yeah, Secules. Well, I bet fucking money you don't know how to say my last name.
Von Herbulus.
Shit, you actually got it.
Fuck yeah.
That's a tough one. You have no idea how many people have said my last name wrong.
Really?
Yeah, it makes really great telemarketing
calls. I think it comes from like having a weird last name. I'm pretty good at sounding out names.
Fair enough.
Yeah.
Secules doesn't seem like that. I just would have imagined it was like Secules.
Yeah.
But then Secules, I was like,
I don't know.
Like
my family doesn't even know how to say it. We don't know anything about our family history. We don't know where we're from. We're like, that's probably how you say it.
It is hilarious to me when you get people that like have somewhat weird last names or whatever and they don't know how to pronounce them.
Yeah.
That one's always funny to me. It's like, it's your name. Who am I supposed to go to?
Yeah. Yep. It's like, yeah, we'll just go with that. Or like a lot of times I tell people like, don't even worry about it. Just try your best and we'll roll with that for the time being.
Yes. So yeah, weird little intro, but still fun nevertheless. So we're playing Rides with Strangers. Now Rides with Strangers currently is a demo. It has not been released as a whole game yet, although it should be coming out soon, and I'll probably be playing the full version when it comes out. It was made by the developers that made, oh my god, I can't remember the name of the game, but it's the one about the deep web and getting kidnapped and shit like that. It's fucking gruesome. It's very scary.
Did you want me to read this?
Yes, like,
oh,
if you could.
Fuck, okay. You are Alora, and you are on your way to the very important job interview in the morning across state. You get into your car late and start heading towards the destination. Unfortunately, your car breaks down, and no cabs are around to pick you up. You must hitch rides with complete strangers to make it to your destination. Be careful, though. You don't know what's out there.
That is very appropriate to what's about to happen.
All right.
See, this is the thing why I was saying, like, I wish it could have been full screen, because it's very dark, and you get the bright background. Okay, so there's a car coming. So you can
pull
E
is like, cool.
And then you want to focus on the actual car itself while you're zoomed. If it goes green, then they see you. You can only zoom for so long, I have no idea why.
Oh, wait.
Yeah, that one's... It wasn't quick enough. Say you want to wait for the next one. Should also probably be worth noting, too, that Brady and I are both drinking, which very common for these. Very common for these videos. But, good to note.
The stars are pretty.
Yeah.
I'm enjoying myself so far. I'm out here. It's cool.
That'll change.
The night air is nice. Oh, the stars go away?
Yeah. And also you'll stop enjoying yourself, which is more of what I meant.
Okay.
All of the stars just die at the same time. He might actually be too far away right now.
Okay. This game is more about the end of the planet.
Yeah.
All the stars are just gonna...
Surprise, surprise.
...die at the same time.
Okay, now I would probably do it. Boy, there was some lag there. There you go. Yeah, so now hit the space bar. Now he's gonna pull over. Oh, you didn't hit the spacebar fast enough.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's a weird thing. I am reminded that once some of the tension has dissolved from this game, that I have a story that I told you that I needed to tell you on this playthrough, the Homeland Security story.
Oh, I'm very intrigued.
Yeah, it's a good one, but I'm definitely gonna wait until the game becomes significantly more passive.
What?
I think you're good.
It said fail.
Oh. Oh, I think you have to wait for it to go green and then hit space, maybe?
First time I was too late, now I'm too early.
Boy, your wife must really love you.
Well played, well played.
That is the idea, after all. So, for those who do not know, which I'm sure is almost everybody, well, all of my viewers, at least, Brady is a comedian, a local comedian to the Bellingham Bellingham?
Right? Yeah.
Bellingham area.
Yep.
Wanted to make sure it wasn't like a fucking Ferndale or something. Although I would imagine Ferndale probably doesn't have much of a comedy scene, so...
I think we go over there sometimes. I actually haven't been myself, but I think sometimes we try to go over there and make a comedy scene happen.
Hmm.
It doesn't go well.
I can imagine. Obviously... okay, now I hit it. There you go.
Much success,
yeah. Okay, yeah, we'll get back into that here in just 1 second. I love how he almost, like, hit you and then didn't. Okay, so now, yeah, you gotta inspect the car.
Okay.
So you just go up to the window and hit E.
Good evening, child.
Oh, God.
What are you doing out there?
Don't worry about it.
Take a seat and let me give you a ride.
So I think yes. Okay, it does say it. So hit, yeah, one. You gotta hit it on the top thing, not the numpad.
Yes, yes. Please, sit.
I already don't like this guy.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure you're going to evolve an appreciation for him. He's like fine wine. He just gets better with age, except he's rapidly aging.
He's already very old.
Okay, so yeah, you can see the sketch meter up top and the distance and everything.
Oh, turn the radio. Do I want the radio on? Sure.
If you'd like.
Oh, it's busted.
This is a dangerous place to be hitchhiking. What is a precious young thing such as yourself
doing out there?
Bear
in mind this is a question.
I can take care of myself.
Okay, also you're going to want to watch out for speed signs, remember?
You can.
Right. Oh my goodness.
Also, you may want to look around periodically too, which remembers
look
the
to my left.
WASD.
Aha. Uh-huh.
Just trust me, that's going to come very in handy eventually.
Well, we have quite a ways ahead of us.
I think
us.
The more you look at him, the
may
more you
I
get
ask,
creeped out.
Where is it you are traveling
to? Oh, that's
to?
My sketch meter.
Yeah.
Okay. Home, yourself?
I just needed to get away.
From what?
Oh, there's a speed thing. Oh, nope, that's a mile marker. Yeah, so Brady, you're a comedian to the Bellingham area. We know this a little bit because Chris
tell,
likes to talk
way,
shit about you.
Present yourself.
That is true.
You have ones that love you. I was forsaken at birth by my mother. I was raised by fathers what would your family say if they knew you were hitchhiking?
I distracted the driver. This isn't my first time. That sounds dirty.
How precocious. I like that.
Oh, Jesus, I shouldn't have said that. Okay, he's still just a dude. Yes, Chris and I have a feud.
Funny
that...
how this world is. How God has set this path in front of me. You see, I have this itch.
Ew.
This itch I can't control.
It's scabies. It's totally scabies.
Away from it,
I would hope it was scabies.
Me to you. It reminds me of the story of the scorpion and the frog. Are you familiar with that?
No, that's not a Bible story. I don't know that one.
How do you know it's not a Bible story?
I've read the Bible. I went to Bible college.
Oh, yeah.
Act against one's nature.
I don't
what do you say, the scorpion and
that?
The bunny, or what?
Scorpion and the frog.
Okay.
So it's a beautiful parable about essentially predatory nature is the big thing. This is... Okay, so yeah, your distance, you're about 25% of the way there, your sketch is about 40%.
God to purge the heretics of this world. In exchange, he suppresses the itch. So
oh,
it has come
God.
Time to ask, are you a God-fearing woman?
I am.
Excellent.
Is my Bible college knowledge going to come in handy here?
Don't know. I guess we'll find out. I don't think so, to be completely honest. But
okay,
we'll see.
Nothing can save me.
Cool. Yeah, you're just, like, permanently boned.
Wait, is it every time I look at him I get more sketched out or less sketched out?
I think you get more sketched out, but it is important to look.
What is the worst thing you have ever done?
Where's my time? I've hurt people. Shit. I just clicked something. I panicked.
Let me take you into my flock.
That's not a nice thing to say, I think.
No. There's... When I turn...
Your sketch meter's...
There's,
whoa! Your sketch meter is very high, by the way.
How do I, like, bail?
I have no idea.
I think it's... I distracted the driver.
I would try looking towards the door and see if there's an option.
Can determine the outcome of their lives.
Oh, yep, there you go.
As in the scripture of James 1:3.
So it's right-click.
You know that the testing of your faith produces perseverance.
Did you try right-click?
You believe that everything happens for a reason.
I rolled it down, then I rolled it back up.
Oh, no, that's left-click.
Oh.
Yeah, I'd answer him real quick.
Sure.
He works in mysterious ways.
Now it says you can tuck and roll. There you go. Well, I mean, actually you're doing pretty damn good for your first time. You're already at like 65% distance. Cool. Obviously your sketch meter is going to go down quite a bit considering you're not with that guy anymore.
Yeah.
That's pretty good.
I'm just on the road.
On the road again.
Oh, but yeah. I was going to say, every time I turn towards him, there's a smudge right here on the screen, and as in the turning process, it looked like he was touching my knee every time, and I was kind of creeped out.
He may have been.
I don't think he was.
I don't think he was either. So you're going to want to stand under a light.
Oh, shit. Okay.
There's one right next to you.
That?
Yeah.
But that's like in the road.
Well,
can I stand in the
road?
You know,
sometimes you just got to stand in the road. Sometimes all you gotta do is do it in the road. You know, like that Beatles song, Do It in the Road?
Mm.
Okay. He might be a little too far away.
Okay.
Oh, it says he sees you. Okay. Oh, you didn't wait for it to go green. You gotta go green, Brady. You gotta go green. So what were we talking about?
Several things.
Seth MacFarlane?
No, several things.
Oh, yes. So, Bellingham Comedy, your feud with Chris.
Yes, it extends far and wide. My favorite part is when we go to shows out of town, and people are like, oh, you're the people that fight on Facebook. Yes, we are.
That's a good thing, though. That's a good thing to have.
Yeah. Like, we did a show in Tacoma together, and we walked in, and we, like, just got there. We, like, you know, kind of shook a couple of hands, and then, like, I did something dumb or whatever, and Chris started making fun of me, and everyone there was like, oh, they're like, this is Chris and Brady fighting in the flesh. This is like Facebook
nice.
IRL.
Nice. I've noticed, too, that you have a very emphatic love for Adam Carolla.
Yeah.
I've seen very little on that, but I know, interesting.
Honestly, I know very little about Adam. I just somehow found the sweet spot of things, how to post things on Instagram, and now he likes all of my statuses.
Sweet.
And so then I got to the point where I started bragging that we were dating, because, you know, obviously he's following me, he's up to date on his boo, which is me.
Here's the real question I have with that.
Yeah.
So let's say Adam Carolla was like, you know what, I want to make the Man Show 2. We're bringing the Man Show back. Brady, do you want to be the co-host of the Man Show?
Sure.
Did you ever see The Man Show? It was actually Adam Carolla and Jimmy Kimmel, funny enough.
Yeah, I mean, a little...
It was a good show.
Oh, I gotta go around to the driver's side.
It was famous for women jumping
on
trampolines.
Yeah, the trampolines with the boobs. I knew that much.
Oh, I forgot about that. Yes, it's the same guy, although a different guy. I think you have to be a little closer. Yeah, try it now.
Good evening, child. What are you doing out there?
You said that last time.
Here, take a seat and let me give you a ride.
So the thing that'll be nice about this is you'll already be most of the way there.
Please.
I think. Sit. I'm pretty sure.
Hopefully.
I think that's
how distance
works,
yeah.
Yeah, I mean, usually. He's just like, let me drive my car in reverse for a really long fucking ways. Yeah.
Cool.
Okay. And your sketch meter is empty. So yeah, you're doing pretty good. Doing pretty good.
We're gonna make it.
Better than I did.
Open the glove box. It's still locked.
Yeah, it's like it literally says it's still locked. This glove box is blocked as well. So Brady, anything you would like to say to
this is a dangerous place
to your
boo,
Adam Carolla? Though I'm curious.
What is it?
Just in case he's watching this.
Things such as yourself.
Does he typically tune in
to my show? No,
yeah,
but if he follows you on Twitter, maybe.
Oh, that's a good point.
I have the Lord to protect me.
Adam, do you have the Lord to protect you? Is it time to talk about Jesus Christ? Adam.
God! Holy fuck! What? Did I die? What happened?
Yeah, you lost.
Okay. Holy moly. So he just...
This is why you gotta watch him.
Oh my god. Okay, so we're started over. We're just back in the car.
Is that what you wanted to say to Adam? I'm curious. So you're just like, oh shit!
What is a precious young thing such as yourself?
Oh boy, that actually scared the shit out of me. I've seen that so many times, too.
Jeez. I'm gonna be a strong, independent woman again. Yeah, I'm a woman, right?
Yeah, I'm Elise.
What?
What's my name?
I have no idea. I don't remember. I think so. You're definitely a woman,
it's
correct?
It's like Elisa or Aralise.
Something. It also might not be anything.
Holy shit. Okay.
But Adam, ooh, huge fan, if you do wind up watching this video. That's not Brady. That's me speaking.
Well, we have quite a ways ahead of us.
Been watching a lot of your political videos, too, just to go on record. To?
I lost a bet. Crazy, right?
Quite a wager, your life. Never know what is out there.
Oh, I hate this.
It's so good, isn't it?
Yeah, I like it.
This is pretty much, my experience, this is every priest.
I can tell by the way you are dressed.
You missed a speed sign. Shit.
You have ones that love you. I was forsaken at birth by my mother and was raised by
That's a
father.
Weird statement. I can tell by the way you are dressed that you have ones that love you. I'm guessing because she's dressed well and she's young.
Probably.
Like, they spent a lot of money on that sweater.
Three.
It's official cashmere. Sure. No, it's legitimate, real
it's
cashmere,
It's official,
though.
Sponsored by the cashmere company.
Yeah, exactly. It's kosher.
Kosher cashmere. We had a conversation about what kosher was the other day at work, and kosher just means blessed by a rabbi, except my coworkers...
Is it blessed by a rabbi, or is it approved by a rabbi?
My understanding, and I could be wrong, but is that it's blessed by a rabbi. Like that the company hires a rabbi and he stands there at the conveyor belt and just blesses everything, like the Cheez-Its as they go past.
I do know that kosher can only apply. So like kosher franks are a big thing.
Yeah.
You're a heretic!
You didn't look enough, I guess. Dude, now you get why I was like, I tapped out. I'm like, I can't do this fucking game.
I jump so much every time. I'm not typically a jumpy person.
I want to say literally,
like,
I really wish I was actually videotaping. I never videotaped the Danny Plays with Friends. But such as when he says jump, he's not exaggerating. He's literally jumping out of his seat.
Yeah.
I have the Lord to protect me.
Oh man, I'm sweating.
So good.
You heretic!
Okay. Well, we have quite a ways ahead of us.
Oh yeah.
May I ask, where is it you are traveling to?
Home, yourself. That seemed to go well last time.
Yeah, that's true.
I just needed to get away.
Oh boy.
Explain
oh, boy,
yourself,
oh, boy.
You creepy old man.
Chef au Boyardee.
Okay. My own personal sketch meter.
Is
I'm bad at this game. Okay, I'm not looking at him enough, apparently.
I guess
just gotta keep an eye on him. What you doing?
You fondling that leg of yours?
No, he's not.
That one actually made me
oh,
jump.
Wait. I can't, like, ask anything about the Bible.
What is a precious young thing such as yourself doing out there?
Oh, fucking creep. Let's call him that.
I will pray for you.
Oh, yeah. Your sketch meter went up so fucking hard. Bear in mind, you can only do that twice.
Yeah, and I didn't get very far.
Yeah.
I feel like I already messed that one up.
I seriously just wish that this game had an option of like, why don't I just fucking walk there? Because it's gonna take forever. Yeah, well, I mean, you know, I don't have to be murdered by a fucking creepy ass priest. So I mean,
I was gonna say, you said every priest is like that, which is probably true, but I do know this one priest, he's pretty legit. He's done this thing called
Is he too legit?
He's too legit to quit the priesthood.
Yes.
But he's we've hung out with him and some other people. It's not just like me and him, but but we like do this thing called pub theology where he just takes us out for pub theology. Oh, okay. at the pub. Bar the you ever been to a bar,
the local pub?
The local pube.
Wait, pube.
Yeah, just a second.
Yeah, no worries. Steam green light.
Oh, okay.
Oh, you missed it.
Well, last time it didn't work. I thought I had to wait for the, like, start.
So anyways, you're going out to a bunch of pubes.
Yeah, with a priest. And this is already a great story. He knows everything about music. And so, like...
Oh, really?
Yeah. Like, everything about any kind of music. And so we were out, and this, like, song came on, and I was like, this is definitely, like... It's, like, 4 seconds into the song. And I'm like, this is, like, a bluegrass cover of... What is it? And he's like, oh, this is Black Sabbath, yo. He didn't say yo, but he knew it was Black Sabbath. And I was like, damn. And then an Eminem song came on, and he started like rapping it like probably almost as good as Eminem. I was really impressed that this priest had all these musical abilities.
That's pretty dope.
Yeah.
That almost makes me think, did you ever see that movie years ago with Johnny Knoxville, The Ringer?
Yeah.
I was like, you think that's impressive? Check this out. Name any movie. Jaws.
That's a good movie. Yeah, right?
Oh boy. So I'll go ahead and get into this now since we're in a bit of a calm. So my Homeland Security story, this is cool. Gonna be hard for me to focus, but I'm gonna try.
Okay.
I think you're really gonna enjoy this.
Okay.
If I ever gave in to fucking Chris's wishes and did stand-up comedy, I would tell this would be one of my jokes.
You should do it.
I don't want to though, is the thing.
Why not?
Here's the thing that's funny. I've thought about it. I'm not nervous about doing it.
Yeah, whatever.
No, seriously, I've performed in front of people so many fucking times.
Oh, that's
I'm not
true.
Nervous at all. But shit. it doesn't feel like my format, you know what I mean? I'm more reactionary. I try to be funny reactionary.
Yeah.
And I get, you know, it's like, oh, well then do crowd work.
Yeah.
Sure. But what if you have a really shitty crowd?
Yeah.
Then all of your material's gone.
Yeah, that was my trouble for a long time, is like, how do you say stuff that's just funny independently.
Yeah. I regurgitate jokes, so like actual jokes that I've heard, which I have a great one that I might tell here in a minute too, that's not mine, that I've just heard that's really funny. But so I like telling jokes, but I don't write them well, I think. So anyways, all of that being said, here's my Homeland Security story, and I don't know really if I'd consider this a joke's format, but it is a story. It's a true... Well, yeah. It's something that really happened.
You've heard that, like, I don't tell jokes as to, like, you know, normal people's standards, right? Like, I tell stories is what I do on stage, mm-hmm. to the point that people have been,
you're
like...
You're saying you do.
Yeah, me. Yeah, I tell stories on stage. And so, like, one time I was on stage, and one of Chris's friends was there, and he was like, so does Brady ever, like, tell jokes? Nope, just these weird stories, yeah. Man.
It reminds me a bit of Tom Segura, if you're a fan.
Oh, yeah, mostly stories and his other albums. I love him. He's great.
Yeah, he's excellent, excellent comedian. So here's my Homeland Security story, which I already feel like just saying out loud, here is my Homeland Security story, is almost a joke of itself. But so as you may know, I think you know this. A lot of people that watch my videos should know this, at least by now.
Child. What are you
I don't
doing
give a fuck about
there?
This guy. You've said the same thing 9 yeah. times.
Take
so,
a seat and let me give
as
it
you may know,
three.
Evan and I, Red Llama, and I co-own Natural Cut Records.
Please sit.
Last year, almost this time, it was pre-summer, so it was late spring. It was like around June, maybe May. Sure. It is not important, actually. We were up in Canada.
Yeah.
And we were going, paying visits to local record shops in Canada, trying to find people that would agree to sell our albums. And we found a good handful. It was a very, very advantageous trip.
This
it was very fun. I can get more into that later, but that's pretty unimportant.
What is
thing.
A precious young thing such as yourself?
Precious
doing
little thing.
Pretty young thing.
I try four.
Oh.
The Lord has brought you to me for a reason, then.
See, because it's godly, so he's not going to call you a heretic. You get what I mean?
Yeah, no, I get it. I'll play the godly route this time. We'll see what happens.
I think that was my experience. That worked very well.
Mm-hmm.
So, So we're in Canada, we have a good time, we make some good sales, we're coming back from Canada. Not a whole lot to be said for that. So we had been bringing demo CDs, right?
Yeah.
To these record stores. Hey, here's a demo, listen to it, tell me if you like it,
well,
and
we have quite a way.
We can work out a deal.
May
to
I ask, where is it you are traveling to?
The fuck was that?
Oh, there's someone in the trunk.
Then I shall get you there before.
Okay, my butthole puckered up. So we're coming back into Canada. We have some of these demo CDs left over because I printed a shitload of them. I have some of these demo CDs left over. Mm-hmm. Coming back into America, you know, the officer at border crossing. What was that? Look over at him real quick, if you would. I just saw it go like white, like it flashed.
I can tell by the way you are dressed.
That's the Holy Spirit.
Yourself.
I hope
you
so.
Have ones that love you. I was forsaken at birth by my mother. Was raised by fathers who are no longer with us. What would your family say if they knew you were hitchhiking?
Do what I want.
I'd say as long as I get home safe.
Yeah, I was gonna say that.
I'm sure they will miss, I mean, that they do miss you.
Why will they miss me?
Yeah, exactly. So, we're coming through border crossing, the officer's there, he's got his dog and everything. Which, I don't have drugs, I don't have any, you know, anything bad, for once. I don't have anything bad, so I'm not worried. And he's going through this little questionnaire.
This
we've all heard this. He's gone through this. At this point, we've all heard it. He's gone through this questionnaire, right? Of
brings me to you.
You know, do you have this? Do you have that? One thing he says, do you have any?
Oh, I didn't realize that was from the Bible. That's what I should have said the first time.
It would be unwise to not learn the lessons of nature as well as His word.
Creepy. Mm-hmm. One of the questions he asks is, he says, "Do you have any?" What was the term he used? I'm sorry, I'm distracted.
I have made a vow with God to purge the heretics of this world. In exchange, he suppresses the...
Essentially, do you have any business merchandise?
Yes.
Nope. He says, okay.
Hells yes, I am.
Excellent.
I mean, hells yes, I am.
Yeah, dog. that's like actually what you say. Yeah, dog. It sounded like he was licking his lips.
Totes someone in the trunk.
Worst thing you have ever done.
Sounds like a fucking bleeding deer.
What about you, Father? That's gonna be not the right answer.
If you must know,
this is good.
Killed, raped, and tortured many.
Brady's fucking face during that.
Boy,
it's pretty excellent.
My passion, but pray
fuck?
To God,
God
to forgive and cleanse me.
Out, totally out.
So yeah, he's like, "Do you have any business merchandise?" I said, "No."
Yeah.
Which, to be fair, I did not realize those demo CDs were considerably business merchandise.
Oh yeah, for
but
sure.
But I didn't realize that.
Yeah.
Now, he says, "Do you have any business merchandise?" I said, "No." He says, "Okay, do you mind if we search your vehicle?" No, because obviously if I say yes, you're going to do it anyways and do it with prejudice. So, go ahead. Now, it was fucking amazing that he looks in my trunk and he comes back and he has this little plastic, plexi sign holder from when I used to manage GNCs. Right.
Yeah.
It's just literally a piece of like broken plexi garbage that used to hold signs. And he comes back and he says, "Do you want to explain what this is?" And I was like, "Yeah, it's a piece of fucking garbage." Mm-hmm. Can I go?
Yeah.
And he's like, "Really? Because it looks more like business merchandise to me." I'm like, "It's not."
Yeah.
It used to hold signs. Now it's all busted and it doesn't fucking do anything.
Yeah.
And he's like, "Well, I'm noticing a bunch of them back there. Why don't you go ahead and pull your car over so we can inspect your vehicle?"
Yeah.
He's like, "Yeah, be fucking kidding me." Now, just to go on record, he did not see my CDs at this point. So we go into the building, and this one guy is like, "Okay, so what the fuck are you doing here?" Like, he's really grumpy. He's very young, so you can tell he's trying to, like, act like hot shit.
Yeah.
And I was like, "You know what? I'm not buying this. I'm not buying this, you piece of crap. I am... I'm going to call your bluff, and I'm going to treat this like exactly what it is. And it's just a fucking shakedown. So I was a huge smartass, which I'm going to say right now, if you ever get interrogated by Homeland Security, do not fucking do that.
I like how you leaned into the mic to give advice about being interrogated by Homeland Security.
If you're being interrogated by Homeland Security, do not be a smartass. Just say, yes, sir, yes, ma'am, whatever. Yeah. Just try and resolve the issue.
Yeah.
So this guy's like, you want to explain the CDs we found in your car? And I realized at this point, I was like, oh, fuck. So they're considering this business merchandise now. Now I've already said that there wasn't business merchandise in there. I need to commit to the lie.
Yeah.
So I said, yeah, we met this band up there called Blue Star, which Blue Star is one of our bands. It literally said Blue Star on there, in my handwriting, on the fucking CDs. I said, yeah, no, we met this band up there, Blue Star, and they gave us some CDs. They're like, they gave you 60 CDs? Yep. Yep, they gave us 60 CDs. They were up there in Canada, and they said, you know, it'd be cool as if you'd take these back with you and give them to your friends.
For like, free.
That's a believable, that's a fairly believable lie.
Yeah.
Because, you know, we work with Natural Cut Records. They could be like, oh, cool, we have a bunch of demos. Could you give them to your friends and acquaintances and, you know, get the fucking word out shit? I was like, that's a believable lie, I think. And he says, well, in that capacity, it's still considerably business merchandise. And I was like, if you fucking say so, it's not mine.
Yeah.
And he's like, well, it doesn't matter. Even if you're carrying it for them, in that way, it's still their business merchandise.
Really?
I was like, that's fucking goofy.
Yeah.
So we go back and forth. Evan and I are sitting in this place for like 3 hours, and they're realizing that I'm obviously not caving and saying this is business merchandise. So a totally new guy comes in, right? He's got like the fucking vest on and everything, you know, the fucking gun and everything. Actually, two guys, but one guy was definitely good cop, one guy was definitely bad cop. Good cop says, okay, so listen, we're going to take you to another building. We're going to take you to a whole new interrogation area, and you're going to be, you know, asked some serious questions, and then we're going to try and get you out of here. Just please try to cooperate to the best of your ability, and, you know, just be honest and forthcoming with us. And believe me, we don't want to keep you any longer than we have to. Is that okay? Are you in agreement with that? To which I said, yeah, sure, whatever, man. Just don't, you know, shove your finger up my ass or anything. Guess what bad cop did?
He shoved his finger up his ass. Up your ass. I'm sorry.
So now I'm in a different room, different than they had been planning on. And, you know, I hear the whole snap of the glove and everything, the lube pouring. And,
are you serious?
Yeah. So I hear, you know, the whole lube pouring and everything, you know, of course, getting ready for my cavity search. Because, again,
like you do,
like you do. Like you do on a typical Thursday eve.
Yeah. Yep.
Actually, this was a Sunday, I think. No, it was either a Sunday or a Monday. I don't remember. If it was a Sunday, that explains it a lot more because, you know, biblical reasons and whatnot.
Priest, it's a callback to the game. We're still
so
playing the game.
I hear the whole snap of the glove.
Okay.
I hear the lube pour and everything. And, you know, I feel the insertion. I'm like, oh, geez, oh, my God. That's crazy. And then I see one hand after the other, you know, fall on the table, like right next to mine. Feel a warm breath on the back of my neck, and he whispers in my ear, and he says, was that good for you too?
This is not a real story.
It was up until the cavity search. That was 100% true up until the cavity search.
You definitely brought me along. I believed all of that, and now I feel I'm never going to Canada again.
No, so yeah, so here's what actually happened. He says, is that okay with you? I said, yes. And he brings me into another. I didn't say don't stick a finger in my ass. I will say this. I had thought. I actually, literally, the thought went through my head to say don't stick a finger in my ass. And every red flag and every warning in my brain said don't fucking say that. Don't you dare. They are definitely going to do it if you say that.
I have that kind of argument with myself quite a lot.
Now you know.
Yeah.
So I did not. And they took us into another room. But let's be honest, wouldn't it be better if I had?
I mean,
it'd be better for everybody, especially me, because win-win.
I was going to say especially me, because there was no finger in my ass by the border guard, but...
Well, that's because you don't want a finger in your ass by the border guard.
I didn't say I don't want it, I just...
The timing wouldn't have been right. It would have been too awkward and too cold.
No, yeah.
So they take us into another room, and there's this very ornery gentleman in there who's watching an NBA game. This is actually absolutely true.
People don't use the word ornery enough.
I say ornery a lot. One thing I also say a lot, too, when I can help it, so when I think of it, is I'll say bully. To be like, having a bully day.
Yeah, bully for you or whatever.
Yeah. So, very ornery gentleman watching an NBA game, wasting his fucking time on that garbage. Not that I have anything against basketball, but the NBA, ugh. So
I don't watch it.
Good. But good for you. So we go in there, and I swear to God, we sit in there for probably about, not very long, 10 or 15 minutes, and he calls us up, and he says, okay, so why is it that you are wasting my fucking time?
What?
And what exactly... is it that you want? And I explained everything to him like I did with the first guy. He said, okay, so I'm going to break this down. I'm going to make this really simple for you, okay? Here's how this is going to go one of two ways, and I'm going to give you the choice. This is true. I swear to God, this part is true. The first part obviously was a joke. This part is true.
Right.
So I'm going to give you one of two choices here. The items are definitely business merchandise. There's no question of that. And it literally, if you actually read the thing that we had been writing on and, you know, not given to you in the fucking first place to read and check off.
Yeah.
If you read it, it does say promotional and demo materials and everything on it.
Oh, shit.
Didn't fucking know that.
Yeah.
But, or samples, I think was one of the terms. Obviously, this is a sample. A demo CD is a sample.
Yeah.
So he says, here's the thing. It is definitely business merchandise. There is no way you're going to get past that. So there's one of two things you can do now. You can continue to commit to the lie,
mm-hmm.
and then you'll be found guilty of perjury. And you can face up to a $25,000 fine when we find you guilty.
Are you serious? Holy shit.
So you can do that. Or you can admit that it is commercial merchandise, was the word I was looking for. Commercial merchandise. You can admit that it was commercial merchandise.
Mm-hmm.
And upon doing so, we will just give you the fine for entering the country with commercial merchandise. So, well, how much is that fine? Because that's the part I gotta know. So it's $10. I was like, are you fucking kidding me? Why didn't you tell me that before? Jesus Christ,
shit.
You could have just literally said, here's the thing, $10 bucks and you can go.
Yeah. No, let's shake him. Let's shake him for 3 hours.
We were there for four hours in total. 4 hours in total before they let us go. They totally, like, dismantled my fucking car to try and find everything, which, by the way, there was one other thing that I found that is also critically important that I'll get back to, too. They dismantled my fucking car.
And then they don't put it back together.
No, they didn't. They put everything back in.
Okay. But
yeah, so they're like, all of your shit's like in the back seat. Like, thanks.
Yeah.
Glad I can find my registration now.
Yeah. No, yeah, I knew that.
We tucked that under the seat. Just, you know, to really fuck you. But,
Jesus.
So yeah, 4 fucking hours spent with Homeland Security over $10. And I'm not gonna lie, if the guy who's just like, I want to be fucking cool, if guy one would have just said, look, here's the thing, this happens all the fucking time, it's $10, if you just pay it, we can have you on your way, I wouldn't have questioned it. I would have been like, $10, here you go, and been fucking gone. I would have been gone like the wind. I'd have been like, I don't give a shit. Here,
but
take my
instead
money.
Instead, they shook you down for like a rate of like $2.50 an hour.
Yeah.
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 And so they just
fuck,
sweat.
Here's what I have to say on that. Fuck Homeland Security. Are you fucking serious? What a goddamn waste of time.
Wow.
And there were other people, too, that came in and out of there way faster than we did.
I'm
so
glad.
Like, there were people that came in while we were there. There was at least 3 or 4 groups of people that came in while we were there that we watched leave. All of them before we left.
I'm glad they put in, what, there's like 4 guys that you interacted with for like 4 hours?
I think it was a total of 5.
Okay.
Somewhere in there.
So they put like 20 man hours in to get $10.
It's so fucking stupid.
Wow. No, they're doing the Lord's work there.
They're
That's
doing
good
the Lord's
stuff.
Work. That's absolutely right. So, the other thing, I had a taser in my car, which I didn't think would be a big deal. Well, not a taser, sorry, a stun gun.
Yeah.
I get that a lot of people are just like, no, they're the same thing. Well, technically they're not. But I had a stun gun in my
car. What's the difference? Tasers?
A taser is an actual, like, pistol.
That shoots the prongs?
A stun gun does not.
Okay.
Which is weird because you think the name of a stun gun.
I always think it's the other way around, yeah.
Yeah, I don't remember the acronym for Taser, but oddly enough, I remember the R of the acronym very easily because it's always fucked me up. The R in Taser stands for rifle.
Oh, what the fuck?
Yeah.
It's like I always thought the Taser was the handheld one.
Tesla something, something, something or other. Like electric rifle. It's not, I don't think it's Tesla, but it's
probably
something fucking goofy like that, where it says rifle in the fucking acronym.
Wow, I did not know that.
Yeah, it's bizarre.
I didn't know it was an acronym, actually. I just thought it was just a name for a thing.
Yeah, no, it is an acronym.
Cool.
So, I had my stun gun in there, and HSA makes a point to say, by the way, you have a stun gun in your car. I was like, yeah, no shit. I knew that. they're like, just to go on record, we don't care about this. At all.
Just the commercial merchandise.
No. Well, yeah. But here's the thing. They're like, because you can bring a fucking taser or a stun gun to the United States. It doesn't matter.
Okay.
But here's the thing. If you would have been caught going into Canada with it, that would have been a problem. I said, seriously? I said, yes. As a matter of fact, any armaments, so a stun gun or mace. So any ladies watching this, know this because this is critically important.
Yeah.
This is what I was told. A stun gun or mace, both of which are very common defense items here in the USA, if you get caught going into Canada with these items, it will be treated as though it is an assault weapon. And you'll be fined as if you were trying to bring a fucking AR-15 into Canada.
What the fuck?
And you will be imprisoned.
Damn. So you hear that, Chris? Wait, Chris and I went to...
I think I've told Chris this.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Chris and I went to Tacoma, and she brought... I think maybe she had mace, but she definitely had
a stun gun. We've talked about it.
Yeah, and as soon as we pulled in, she, like, pulled it out. She was ready. She, like, rolled down the window. She's just, like, ready to, like, Tacoma. Get any pedestrian with it.
Yeah. So that's very phenomenal information, in my opinion, to know.
Wow.
You can literally be imprisoned for trying to go into Canada with mace... or a stun gun. But the mace part, man, that's the part that fucks me up. Like, mace is so common. Like,
yeah, everybody has mace.
Everyone has fucking mace. You don't even think about it.
No.
And that was the thing. I didn't think about the fact that I had a stun gun in my car either, because it's just...
They never asked that at the border. I feel like if it was that big of a deal, they should ask it.
They do. They ask if you have any weapons. But the thing is, they don't ask, do you have those kinds of weapons?
Because you don't think of those as weapons necessarily.
Exactly. You just think of them as like a
self-defense. Yeah.
Yeah. So... Yeah, that's so fucking crazy to me. Let's get back into the game, shall we?
Yeah, I'm going to take my sweatshirt off because I'm sweating.
Oh, yeah, please do.
Because I'm terrified.
Oh, here's my joke that I was saying, by the way. Here's my favorite joke I think I've ever heard to date. I've never told this joke. There's two things about this joke. I've never told this joke and had somebody not laugh at it.
So should I try not to?
If you like. If you want to be that guy.
I'll react to it appropriately.
Okay. I've never had somebody not laugh at this joke. Yeah, he's way too close. Oh. I've never had somebody not laugh at this joke. I've also never had somebody wait till the punchline.
Okay.
Which is a very weird characteristic for a joke. Feel free to use this joke, by the way, if you like.
I write my own stuff. But okay, we'll see what
certainly
happens.
Certainly not. Well, you know, when you're having a drink with someone
or
something.
Okay, cool.
Not on stage.
No, I'll tell my coworkers on Monday, probably.
There you go. So this is my favorite joke I've ever heard in my entire life. So a man gets out of prison. And this is, obviously distinctly a joke. Wow, look at that turning.
I know, right?
Turn on a fucking dime. Okay, so a man just gets out of prison. He's been imprisoned for 45 years, let's say, although it's
That's
a weird
while,
time
yeah.
frame, quite a while, for a very long time. He just gets out of prison, doesn't have a dollar to his name, but he's told himself this entire time, Jesus, just no one, huh? Are you standing under a light?
Yeah, I was, but I'll go under this light because I think it's brighter.
So, I did notice the icon came up. So he just gets out of prison, doesn't have a dollar to his name, but he's decided that the first thing he wanted to do when he got out of prison is just get totally shit-faced.
Like you do, yeah.
Yeah,
no, that makes sense.
Like you do. So he leaves the prison. He goes to the nearest bar he can find. And he walks in. He assesses the place. He walks up to the counter. Talks to the bartender. The bartender says, what can I make for you? And he says, you know, out of curiosity, you're not a betting man, are you? Bartender says, okay, well, yeah, I'm interested. What kind of bet do you have in mind? He says, I bet you $10. I bet you $10 that right here, right now, I can bite my left eye. Bartender says, I'd fucking pay to see that. So yeah, here's $10. I bet you can't do that. Guy takes out his prosthetic left eye, and he bites down on it, puts it back in his head. The bartender says, okay, fine, you got me. Here you go. Take your
good
fucking
evening,
money.
Good child.
Yeah.
What are you and, doing out there?
The guy here. Buys $10 worth
take
of drinks,
a seat and
which is obviously we know
eye.
Not that much. And he goes off and he, you know, enjoys them. And yeah, he's not really feeling anything. So he goes back up and says, I got another bet for you if you'd like. I bet you another $10 that I can bite my right eye. He said, there's no way you have another fucking prosthetic eye. Like, you definitely saw your way up here. There's no way you have two prosthetic eyes. He's like, should be an easy bet then. You want to take the bet? Guy says, okay, fine, fucker. Puts $10 on the counter, and he pulls out his dentures and bites his right eye. See, he laughed before the punchline.
That's not the punchline?
That's not the punchline.
Okay.
So he's like, okay, fine. Order your drinks and get the fuck out of my sight. Bartender's pissed. He goes off. He has his drinks. He's you know, feeling... It's been a while since he's really had any drinks, so he's, you know, getting kind of tipsy, but it's not enough.
Yeah.
So about 10 minutes pass. He goes back up, and he says, look, I feel bad. I want to give you a chance to earn your money back, okay? I bet you $20, it's double or nothing, that I can piss in this shot glass all the way across the bar and not spill a drop. Bartender's like, this isn't some fucking pub, dude. Like, there's just no way you're gonna do that. He says, well, easy bet, right? You make your money back.
Yeah.
Bartender says, okay, fine. Puts $20 on the counter. He's like, let's see it. So the man goes to one corner of the bar, or one side of the bar, puts the shot glass down, goes to the other side.
Yeah.
Pulls out his dick and just starts pissing all over the floor. Obviously, he's not even close. He's not trying.
Yeah.
The bartender laughs because he's won, right? He fucking beat this guy. He laughs. He grabs his cloth, jumps over the counter, walks up to the man slowly, gets down on his hands and knees, and starts cleaning up. And he says, "You owe me my money back, you son of a bitch." And he's like, "I don't care. I bet those guys over there $200. I can make you clean up my piss with a smile on your face."
That's good. I like that. That's a joke my dad would like.
It's a good one.
Yeah.
It's my favorite.
Please sit.
I always forget to say, like, he grabs a mop instead of he grabs his cloth.
Yeah.
Because who the fuck is going to clean up pee-pee with a cloth?
On their hands and knees.
That's a little icky. Yeah.
A little gross. I don't think I'd want to do that.
How do you have no distance?
Yeah, I'm back at the beginning.
A dangerous place.
Maybe it's because you sat for so long.
Maybe.
What is the precious thing such as yourself doing out there?
I'd try the sheepy. Number 4.
Thanks.
That was close.
I know,
the
right?
The Lord has brought you to me for a reason.
You missed a sign. And you've actually missed two already.
Discovery. Oh, shit.
I know, dude. Gotta step up that game.
Yeah. I'm still thinking about that guy on his hands and knees smiling and ragging up piss.
Yeah.
Well, we have quite a ways ahead of us.
So that's my favorite joke.
May I
that's
ask,
a good one.
Where is it you are traveling to?
I don't think I said that one yet.
How perfect.
Ooh.
I would love to offer my home to you.
I hate this guy.
I think we all hate this guy. If it were me, I'd probably be getting the fuck out pretty soon.
Okay.
I'm just saying. That's just me.
What is the worst thing you have ever done?
Oh, car's going too fast.
What?
That sounded like someone sharpening a knife.
Yep, that it did. Oh.
We all have, child. Let me take you into my flaw.
Oh, no. Oh, I don't like this. I have sweat pouring into my eyes right now.
I can see that.
Maybe I'm crying.
A person's faith can determine the outcome of their lives. As in the scripture of James 1:3, you know that the testing of your faith produces perseverance. Do you believe that everything happens for a reason? Or is it just chaos?
That seems like it'll advance the plot. What happens when I get my, like, my freak out meter goes
full?
Too high? Yeah.
I don't know. Oh, look at that. You're almost there. Is that just once or twice, though?
Oh, I think it reset last time because that was my second time.
I think you're right.
Yeah, that makes sense. Okay. Whew.
That was intense.
That's getting pretty intense.
That was a little bit like camping. I thought that was a fucking car for a second. I was like, wait, what the hell? That box has no back.
Yeah. Huh. And from this side, you can see through it.
I'll be dipped. Dude, I love living right next to a Taco Bell. Let me tell you. I can get diarrhea anytime I want.
Oh, gosh.
Speaking of diarrhea, have you seen that they just created a new... I have no idea why the fuck they call it this. It's amazing. They created something now called the Triple Double Crunchwrap.
Huh.
I'm going to let that sink in to everyone who just heard that. The Triple Double Crunchwrap.
I don't think mathematically you're allowed to just layer things in that way.
I don't think so. Now, here's the thing. Here's what it is, right? Let me learn you. It's a Crunchwrap Supreme, but you know the Crunchwrap has the flour tortilla, tostada, beef, cheese, and then it's got nacho cheese, sour cream, and lettuce, tomatoes, yeah. All that shit. I'm amazed that I knew that not only fully but readily.
Yeah, you really rattled that off like you currently work at Taco Bell.
Yeah, I know.
Even in the past, like current.
No. So it's essentially exactly the same thing, except you add an extra tostada, an extra beef and cheese, right? So uh-huh. It's like the double cheeseburger of Crunchwraps, right?
Yeah.
But it's called a triple double.
No, that's...
Well, no.
The name is wrong.
It.
Yeah.
Stop it, Taco Bell. Go home, you're drunk. I did love
Can I get a triple double Crunchwrap? So you just want six Crunchwraps?
Yeah.
Yes, please.
Yes, please. Here's something I'll say that's amazing about that, though. If you are somewhere in the world and you're thinking, I'd like to try that, although I don't think they have those in Kuwait, so maybe stick to America. But if you're somewhere in, let's just say, Missoula, you're thinking, that sounds good. I'll give that the old shotterino. Amazingly, they have a Crunchwrap box, right? Crunchwrap box is $6. Oh. Or sorry, not the Crunchwrap box. The Triple Double Crunchwrap box, $6. And you can add jalapenos to it for free, which is delicious.
Obviously.
Obviously.
Why wouldn't you do that?
I agree. And you can get a crunchy taco and a drink, which is what the normal Crunchwrap meal is.
Good evening, child.
And a free Doritos Locos taco. So it's like the Crunchwrap meal, except that the Crunchwrap is twice as big, and you get a free Doritos Locos taco. Here's the thing. It's 50 cents cheaper than the regular meal.
What?
Yeah, the regular meal is $6.50. This is $6. You get the twice the Crunchwrap.
The regular meal is $6.50. This is $6. By the way, I work at Taco Bell.
Yeah.
Every day.
Well, no, I just remembered that from the first time I went and got it. From the only time I went and got it. I don't know what it is. I don't remember names very well. I remember numbers exceptionally well. That's why I get really awkward when I see someone like entering their PIN. I have to look away.
Yeah.
Because I'm like, I don't want to accidentally remember your like fucking PIN or phone number or something. Because I probably will. Gotta go with the God thing again.
Doing this one. Is that the God thing?
Yes.
The Lord has brought you to me for a reason, then.
We might make it. We're close.
Yeah, you're very close. This will be the first time I've seen somebody make it, if you make it. So that'd be cool. I thought he was staring at you. It's actually made my heart fucking skip a beat. I'm gonna say this should probably be the last attempt either way.
God! Why? Why?
That was Rides with Strangers. We had a lot of laughs. We had a lot of fun. thank you, Brady, for being here. Brady, do you have anything you would like to bring up? Anything you'd like to promote or endorse or anything like that? I know you recently just started using a very special kind of brand of cream. Why don't you tell me about that?
Oh, yeah. It's for the genitals.
Okay.
Yeah.
So it's a genticular cream.
A genticular cream. You can
that's the right word.
You can get it at Target and Kmart. But nothing higher end than that.
You can get it at Kmart. That's my favorite store, Blue Light Specials.
Yeah, and Target.
I fucking hate Kmart, actually, but...
I haven't been to a Kmart in like 6 years, so obviously I do my...
Kmart since like yesterday. No, I went to one recently, but not that recently, thank God.
Yeah, it's been a while. Obviously, I shop for most of my genticular cream at Target, but...
Usually when I'm shopping at Kmart, I'm shopping for depravity.
Like you're going to purchase some?
No, I'm just going to find it.
Oh, okay.
I'll just sit in the men's clothing section and realize that 90% of what they offer are empty hangers. So your stand-up comic. Do you have any shows coming up, which I'll say bear in mind, this will probably be about...
Yeah, I was like, when does this come out?
It'll probably be about... So today's what, Saturday? It'll probably be up around this time next week.
Okay.
It takes about a week, typically.
What do I have after that?
I am doing... the movie magic. For the viewers,
it takes about a week. No, I know. This happened a week ago.
Yeah, exactly. Today is... what is today's date? So you guys know specifically. Today is Saturday, March 18th. Now you know.
I have in May. I'm on the That's Gateway Show.
I'm sorry. What? I was interrupting you.
Yeah, you were. In May.
Oh man. Okay.
In May, I'm on the Gateway Show in Bellingham at the Upfront Theater.
Gave me a good dick.
Yeah, I think it's on May 7th, but I just checked my phone calendar, and the only thing that comes up is pay energy bill. So hopefully it's that day. But it's the only May Gateway Show that's happening in Bellingham. Basically, the premise of that is comedians go up on stage and tell some jokes, and then they go to an undisclosed location and smoke some weed, and then get on stage again and try to tell more jokes. It's going to be a problem because I don't typically smoke the weed.
Now, here's the thing.
I'm going to fall apart.
I can't condone the smoking of the weeds in the state we live in Colorado. Oh, wait. We live in Washington where it's also legal, like in Colorado.
Yeah.
No, I don't care. Do what you want, fam. Just don't do heroin. That's pretty much... to all of my listeners, don't do heroin.
Yeah.
That's pretty much all I have to say on that.
Go nuts. The main message here is don't do heroin.
Do nutmeg, do cocaine, and do the meth. No, don't do meth. I actually specifically said don't do meth in one video, and I stand by that. Also, don't do nutmeg, because the high is not very good, and the hangover lasts a very long time.
Really?
And it's also very easy to die from.
Really?
Nutmeg, yeah.
Yeah, I've heard of that, but I haven't tried it. But
here's the thing. If you're thinking about doing nutmeg as a drug and not as a delicious way to season your pancakes...
in the autumn.
Just do some cocaine. Just do some cocaine.
Yeah.
You heard it here first. DannyVNCR said, just do some cocaine. The more you know.
Holy
I don't
moly.
Actually endorse cocaine. Don't fucking do that. But I mean, if you want to, go ahead, but I'm not going to endorse it. So... with that, you've got the Gateway Show, May 7th, we are hoping.
I think so. I'm pretty sure.
Where could somebody find you if they wanted to see your love affair with Adam Carolla on the Twitters, the Facebooks? You have a personal Facebook, right?
Something yeah, like it's just, yeah, it's my personal Facebook. Okay. My name is Brady Sekules. That's BradyS as in Sam, Sekules. It's like Hercules, but Sekules.
Nice.
Is a lot of how people remember it.
So what about the Twitters? What is your Twitter handle?
It's at Brady Sekules. I'm super creative.
Yeah. But Brady, thanks for being on.
Sure thing.
May 7th. Are you doing the Way North show?
Yeah. I'll be on the open mic portion. But cool. Yeah.
I will be there as well. I don't remember when it is, though. I know it's in April.
April 9th.
Is it? Yeah. I thought it was the 11th.
I believe it's the 9th.
I think you're probably right. You probably know better than I do because you're actually going to fucking be there.
I'll look it up.
Well, I'll be there too, but not performing.
Nope, not June. April... Yeah, 9th.
Cool. April 9th. So April 9th in Mount Vernon, Washington, which is very near where I live and where probably most of the views from this video are going to be coming from, I would imagine, at the Farmstrong Brewing.
Yep.
I have no idea what time it is, but I'm sure it can't be that fucking hard to find.
I think it starts at like 8 or 9 or something.
Boom shaka. The last one, I think, started at like 6.
Oh, maybe it's earlier. Maybe it's 7.
I don't know.
You keep talking. I'll look it up real quick.
So I'll keep talking. So, guys, how have you been? How was I've noticed you've been wearing that new matte foundation. I really appreciate
it. Oh, you're right. It starts at 7.
Boom.
Yeah.
That winged eyeliner your boyfriend didn't notice. I noticed.
Wow, you're a good guy.
And it's very lovely. You take care of yourself very well. You're beautiful. And no, don't ever let anyone tell you you're not. There's a little bit of motivation for you.
I feel motivated.
To the show. Come hang out with Brady and Chris and I, and watch Brady and Chris hate each other because it's fucking hilarious. It's fucking hilarious.
Oh god.
I did love though that she had literally just been on my thing days before the last show you guys were at.
Yeah.
And she had gotten the implant in her arm, the birth control or whatever.
Oh god.
And she's like, Brady, check this out. And you just like slap the shit out of it.
Yeah. She was like, feel in my arm, you can feel like the grain of rice little bulge of my implant. And I was like, I don't want to do that. And she was like, touch it. And I was like, no. And she's like, it would mean a lot to me if you touched it. And I was like, that's why I'm not going to touch it. I'm going to deny you that joy in life. And she was like, please. So then I just smacked it. And she had to go in the other room and cry for a while. I felt real bad.
It was pretty fucked up. Like, it was really funny, but it was pretty fucked up.
Yeah.
She literally, I think, literally did the Let's Play that I've been uploading for fucking ever, the Clock Tower thing, because it was so long. The total play duration of that was like 5 hours.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, it was crazy. But she had done that like the day before that. So she was talking about it on the fucking thing. And then that happened, and it was great.
Yeah.
Okay, so before this goes on any longer, Brady, thanks for being on. Guys, go check out at Brady CQs on Twitter. And while you're at it, smash that motherfucking like button. Leave some comments, even if they're just death threats. Like, trust me, I love the haters.
I do too. It makes it a lot of fun.
We all do. We sure do. And subscribe if you haven't already. Subscribe to Brady. Don't subscribe. I mean, do subscribe to me, but subscribe to him. Follow him. Stalk him.
Follow me home.
Tell me what his pant size is.
I think it's 30.
No. That's what they're supposed to do.
Oh, no, yeah. It's not at that at all.
Okay. Thanks for watching, guys. Until next time, Danny Vinker out.